Welcome to Fabco. This is a brand new channel. We're going to be using this channel to demo how we manufacture mandrel bends in-house, along with how we produce silencers and lots of other things. We're going to be using this channel to go over how we do things like make fully mandrel bent sections and some of the advantages of using those and how that can speed up your exhaust production. We can go through one-offs, the challenges of doing one-offs, and overall how a mandrel bender works. So the mandrel in mandrel bending is this piece here, which sits right in the middle of the bender. These come in all different shapes and sizes. For bending tube, they're going to be round, but they also come in different materials for bending different grades of tube, different materials of tube. And then they also have different amounts of mandrel balls on the end and different sizes of mandrel balls. Again, depends what you're bending. The material, the radius, all those kinds of things. But that's what makes a mandrel bender a mandrel bender. This piece which sits in the middle, and that stays in the middle of the tube as it's bent, and that is how you retain the perfect shape of the tube all the way through the bend. You can keep a perfect constant radius with no deviations in diameter all the way throughout the bend. So this mandrel is made from brass. They do come in different materials for bending different materials. Brass is what's used for bending stainless steel, and that's what we've got here. This setup is for bending 1.5D, 1.5 millimeter wall thickness, 50.8 OD stainless steel tube. This part is the bend die. Now, the job of the bend die is to help retain the internal shape of the tube as it's bent. Once the tube is clamped, it is then drawn around the bend die to whatever the desired angle is, and this will retain the shape of the inside of the diameter of the tube. So built into the bend die, we've got one half of the clamp, and on the other side, we've got the other half of the clamp. So these two pieces come together. When the bend die is in its home position, this half of the clamp drives in, and that's what holds the tube in position with the mandrel inside it. The clamps actually come in different sizes and different lengths. So this is one of the biggest challenges with mandrel bending. You'll often find that you want to have, on a fully bent section, you might want to have two bends really close together. And that's not always possible, depending on bend angle and length of clamp. One of the things that you have to bear in mind during the design process of any exhaust system is what the limitations are of the bender. For example, this set of tooling has an 125 millimeter length clamp. And that means that the minimum distance we can do between any bend, even if it were 280 degree bends, is 125 millimeters. Now, we can reduce that by having a shorter clamp and a shorter clamp section on the bend die, but with less clamp pressure on the outside of the tube, you've then got more room for the tube to slip during the bending process. So the bigger the bend angle, the more chance you're going to get some slippage. So with 125 millimeters, we can guarantee that we can get 180 degree bend with no slippage. As soon as we start to reduce that clamp distance down, we start to increase the chance of slippage. So if we bring the mandrel back, you can then see the wiper die, which is on the inside of the bend die. And that is crucial to producing a nice quality bend. So what we can see now, next to the mandrel, is the wiper die. That part is crucial to getting a nice quality bend. A worn or old wiper die will increase the chances of any kind of surface ripples on the inside of the bend. Because as these clamps come together, and as the pressure die comes towards the tube and pushes it into the wiper die, It's the job of the wiper die to reform that stainless steel as it's bent. The wiper die has to have just the right amount of pressure from the pressure die so that as the tube is bent and the outside of the tube gets shorter and the inside of the tube gets longer, you'll end up with material which needs to be reformed, and that is the job of the wiper die. Okay, so this is an example of how as the tube is bent, it gets longer on one side, longer on the inside and shorter on the outside. So we've done a bend here which was short, so there's no leg on the other side. This would be okay if you were making a 45 degree bend or something like that and you didn't need the wastage. But you can see how as the tube is bent, where the inside gets shorter and the outside gets longer, you end up with this angle on the end. That's because the tube is being reduced in length on the outside and increased in length on the inside. And it's the job of the wiper die to reform all that tube and keep it a nice round shape. So when it comes to making a mandrel bend, there's a few key points which make a good bend over a bad bend. So one of the first is, as we've already covered, a good setup on the mandrel bender. So having the right tooling for the job, the correct mandrel and mandrel balls for the material you're bending, having a correct pressure die setup, and having your wiper die all in the correct position. All of these things take a little bit of time to tweak and perfect if you want to make really nice bends. One of the next most important things is having a clean deburred piece of tube ready for bending. So our piece of tube here is completely deburred inside and outside. It's clean, there's nothing inside it. This, once bent, will produce a clean, nice bend with no sharp edges, no burrs, ready to be used in an exhaust system straight away. So another key point to producing a good quality bend is having the correct lubrication inside the tube. So we're going to be doing the bending about in the middle of the tube. So that's where we need to make sure we get our lubricant. And we just want a very small smear around in there. And that's going to be more than enough for the mandrel balls to ride over and not cause any scoring, not get damaged, and not, crucially, not damage the inside of the tube whilst it's bent. We need to make sure that it's lubed correctly so that as the tube is drawn around the bend die and over the mandrel, there's no resistance, nothing that could cause the tube to start to slip out of the clamps and retain a perfect bend inside and outside. So we've got the tube now over the mandrel. The mandrel's in the correct position. We've got our seam at the top. You'd always want to bend with the seam at the top. Now, if you get a bend that doesn't have the seam at the top, that means that the seam has been stressed. If the seam were on the outside, as we've explained, as the bend is produced, the outside of the tube gets stretched and the inside of the tube gets reduced down. Now, we want to put the least amount of stress through this seam weld as possible. The least stress we put through the seam, the less chance there is of the seam breaking as the exhaust system goes through several heat cycles. So inside of the bend die and the clamps and the pressure die, it's all clean, there's no debris, there's nothing that's going to be forced into the tube and cause indentations in the outside, nothing that's going to cause us any resistance. The cleaner this operation is, the better quality of bend we'll get at the end. So we've now got the clamp in position and it's clamping the tube between the clamp on the outside and the bend die on the inside. The mandrel is sat inside there, ready to help keep the tube shape right. And the next process is for the pressure die to come across and put pressure on the wiper die, and the bend arm will begin to move around and produce a 90 degree bend. So the pressure die has now put pressure on the tube with the mandrel in the middle up against the wiper die. And the bend arm is starting to move around into the 90 degree position. Once the bend arm has reached the 90 degree position, the clamp will release, the mandrel will retract, and the pressure die will retract. Once they're all retracted, the bend arm will start to move back around into the 0 degree position. Once the bend arm is back in the 0 degree position, the mandrel moves forward. The mandrel needs to retract in order for the bend arm to move back to the 0 degree position without breaking the mandrel off inside the tube. Once the mandrel is pushed forward, it then reveals a perfect mandrel bend. So now if we pull the bend off of the mandrel, we can see we've got some excess lube inside which can be wiped off, which we would do before the bend was shipped out. And we can see we've got some minor clamp marks in there. Bending stainless steel, it's almost impossible to bend it without any form of clamp mark. The clamp marks that we've got on here are very minor and would polish out easily if you needed them to be gone. We can't really see any marks from the bending process. We can see on the outside how the tube is being stretched. It's been cold worked, and stainless steel will cold work. And on the inside, it's been reduced. But there's no rays around the wiper die area where the bend has begun. There's no lumps or bumps in the back of the bend where the bend has finished. And the outside has a perfect radius with no deviation in outside diameter at all during that whole bend. So now we're going to demo how we would do a multi-bend section with several bends and some rotations in it. So we've got the tube in the bender and mounted in the chuck at the far end, the Z-axis chuck. And what we're going to do first is a 45 degree bend. So nice and easy, a plain 45 degree bend, and then we're going to rotate the tube through 180 degrees and do another 45 degree bend. We've now completed one 45 degree bend. Now, the first limitation we'll come into with mandrel bending as we draw this tube forward is a minimum clamp distance. So if we wanted two 45 degree bends right next to each other, the reason we can't do that is because the tube needs to be clamped as it's bent. So we can't clamp that piece of tube. With specialist compound cut dies, it could be done, but a set of dies compound cut to do that kind of specialist short distance or at a compound angle would run into the thousands. So for a one-off job, it's almost never going to be financially viable to do that way. So we need to take into account this minimum clamp distance. So this clamp is 125 millimeters long. So that is technically the distance we can do between bends before we start our next bend. Now, depending on the bend angle, we can cheat that a little bit. We can start to push that tube in a little bit further and clamp slightly across the bend. Depending on the bend angle, we can get away with that. So it's something to be aware of. Depending on the diameter, the clamp distance will change. The smaller the diameter, the smaller the clamp distance. So I'm going to demo this one where we clamp slightly across the bend, just as an example of what we can do when it comes to pushing the machine to its limits. So we've got the tube mounted at a less than 125 millimeter distance, and we're going to clamp slightly across the bend and do another bend. And that's just going to be an example of what happens if you don't stick to that 125 millimeter clamp distance, clamping across the bend and the marks it will leave. So as you can see, we've now got a clamp line right across this bend. That hasn't come out that badly. The more we start to reduce that distance, the worse that'll be. So it's something to bear in mind with regard to designing sections for mandrel bending. So now the tube has been released from the clamp. We've done our three bends with our two rotations, and we've now got this full section with no weld joins in it. So this is the real advantage of mandrel bending and using mandrel bent sections. If you're making the same thing repeatedly, cutting it and welding it together, this is a far better way of doing very accurate, very repeatable work with almost no labor. There's no cutting or welding involved here. This is all just mandrel bent. So if you have a section of tube that you make from off the shelf mandrel bends, and you're looking for a faster way or a more cost effective way of doing it, this is definitely the way to go.